Good morning, and thank you for joining us here on Renew, this daily devotional for you. And again, it's Monday morning, and our prayer is that you have a great start to your week this week and a wonderful week. Today's devotional is entitled A Renewed Power. Something that we all appreciate is power here on this in this house. I appreciate electricity and the power that we get. But we're not going to talk about material things or physical things. We're going to talk about spiritual power this morning. Our scripture is found in Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 15. And we're going to read through to verse number 20. And it says this, "Wherefore I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto all the saints, cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints." And here's our theme verse for the day, verse 19. "And what is the exceeding greatness of his power to usward who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ, whom he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places." And what a prayer that we see here from Paul for the Ephesian believers, and certainly a great prayer for each and every one of us. There is so much that Christ wants to give us. And what we're talking about here is not material wealth, but spiritual blessings. One of which, that we might know, as we can see in verse number 19, exceeding greatness of his power to usward who believe, towards those who believe. We need God's power both personally and corporately. How many would agree that you need God's power? I certainly know that I need it. But what is required for his power to be released upon us? The truth is this, the answer is the same whether we're talking about individual believers or if we're talking about local churches as well. And I want to just give you four thoughts. The first one is this, and it's kind of like going back to the basics, back to the fundamentals on how we can get God's power. Faith in God and his word. It is essential to believe that the scriptures are absolutely true and sufficient for life and for godliness. Anytime a believer, a Christian, begins to question the Bible's inerrancy, sufficiency, or clarity, that individual has denied the source of its own power. Number two, complete dependence upon God. Jesus said in John 15 and verse number 5, that apart from me, ye can do nothing. Let me read the verse for you real quick. I am the vine, Jesus said. Ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. And here it is, for without me, ye can do nothing. Also, the truth is this, God's power is perfected in us when we are weak and fully rely on him. 2 Corinthians 12:9, another great scripture that I want to read to you to back up that thought. Familiar verse to many of you, it says, "And he said unto me," Jesus saying, "my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in mine infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." Number two, dependence on God. Number three, obedience. We can't expect God's power to flow through us when we are living in outright sin or rationalizing partial obedience. but he's always ready to strengthen those who obey him. And then finally, again, as we look at these basics, prayer. When we come humbly to the Lord with our needs and in submission to his will, we can be confident that he will do the work on our behalf. Sometimes we think that God empowers us to achieve goals, but in actuality, the Spirit comes to live Christ's life through us. Think about this final statement. His power flows in us when we submit every area of our lives to his authority, including our plans, our desires, and our future. Let me ask you this question. Have you made that full commitment and submitted to including your plans, your desires, and your future completely to God's authority? Again, four basics. Number one, for having God's power, we must have faith in God and his word. We can trust his word. Dependence on him. Number two, complete dependence. Number three, obedience. And number four, prayer. Heavenly Father, I need your power. We need your power. I pray today that you will give us a renewed power. Lord, that we would just look at some of the basics of what you have, the fundamentals that you've given to us. I pray for each one watching now that, Lord, we would cling to these scriptures and what we heard today so that we can experience your power doing the work in and through our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. It is my prayer that each and every one of you, just as we saw Paul's prayer for the Ephesian believers here, that we continue to allow Christ's power to work within us. Remember our theme verse, Romans 12:2, not to be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of our minds, which is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Today's devotional, a renewed power. Let's pray for God's power in our lives for his glory.